This is Matthew Kratter from Trade University, and today I want to talk about Bitcoin, music, and otherworldly beauty. This is going to be a more aesthetic or spiritual or mystical version of Bitcoin. I like to sometimes mix things up on Friday and do something different. When I look at Bitcoin, when I see the four-year halving cycle, when I see the two-week difficulty adjustment, when I see its basis for consensus in proof of work, and the presence or the complete absence of a founder who was so selfless that he left the project really early on and allowed it to flower and develop on its own. I see a protocol. I see something that reminds me of these beautiful ornate European clocks. There was a certain fascination with these, especially in the late medieval or early Renaissance times, trying to model the universe as a timepiece. And this really reached its culmination at Versailles with some of the clocks that were made there. But when I see these, I see Bitcoin in this tradition of beauty and mechanical perfection as well. And I've mentioned this before in the channel, but I often ask myself, how did a human being or multiple human beings actually invent something like Bitcoin, something so beautiful and so profound? You could see Satoshi as a sort of modern Isaac Newton, who synthesized many things. Satoshi synthesized economics, the school of Austrian economics, and gold, etc., with electricity, mathematics, cryptography. It's a very strange and beautiful synthesis. Bitcoin itself is also like a mirror. It's a strange looking glass that when you look into it, it displays or reflects back your true time preferences. Bitcoin enters your life, and before long, if you go deep enough, it has you thinking about 10 generations in the future. It has you thinking about regenerative agriculture. It has you thinking about politics and economics and all these different disciplines. Bitcoin itself, just the protocol, has an otherworldly quality to it, like it was given to the world by an advanced interstellar species. And I would attach a non-zero probability that this actually happened. I think it's a very small probability, but it just seems so otherworldly to me and so bizarre and so out of nowhere that it wouldn't surprise me if this came from somewhere else. Bitcoin has this very noble, beautiful feel to it. And when you study altcoins, by contrast, they're much more cynical. They have these large pre-mines, they have large marketing budgets, and they're basically mostly corporations masquerading as decentralized protocols, but actually having these unregistered securities. So Bitcoin is noble. By contrast, altcoins are cynical. They're postmodern. They're ironic. They're nihilistic as well. You can just look at the names of some of them. Some of them are cute. Some of them are funny. Dogecoin, I'm not even going to say the name of this one because I don't want to get in trouble with the YouTube algorithm. Shiba token, etc. These are funny, but these are very postmodern. They're very cynical. They come and go. They're not timeless and otherworldly, and they're always changing, just like Ethereum is always changing its monetary policy. There's nothing ethereal about Ethereum. It had a giant pre-mine. It's very grounded in the earth. It's a very cynical form of money, and it's a very insecure form of money as well. When you think about Bitcoin, I think another way of approaching it is thinking about it as the Platonic form of money. It's money reduced to its absolute abstract essence. And there's that famous quote where Satoshi talks about, imagine a gray metal with no utility. When you read that passage, and I'll link to it below, you begin to get an idea that he's talking about something very abstract and very beautiful, like a Platonic form. But that's also very useful that you can send across distances. As I said, Bitcoin has this otherworldly, numinous quality to it, like the best music. And I want to end this video today. It's going to be a very short video, but I want to end it with two examples of two of my favorite pieces of music. And I think this sort of timeless, otherworldly quality that they have is something that I associate with Bitcoin. And I associate with the greatest creations and inventions of humanity. Bitcoin is really in this category of timeless, otherworldly music. The first example is Bach's Goldberg Variations, which were published just 9 years before he died. This is a composition that was written for keyboard, as I said, by J.S. Bach, Johann Sebastian Bach, and it consists of basically a theme followed by 30 variations. The theme is called an aria, and I'm not sure where Bach took it from or whether he composed it himself. The most famous example of this is Glenn Gould, the pianist, recording of it. He did a version very early in his career that really made his career. And then he revisited this piece just a year or so before his death, and he made this very famous recording. It was recorded in 1981. So this is the theme, this is the aria on which all the variations are based. This is what I'm talking about when I mean a numinous spiritual quality. And you can see that Glenn Gould himself was a very strange guy. He used to play piano on a very low bench. He would sing along and hum and hunch over the keyboard. He had many personal problems, but the music that he created and his interpretations of Bach are just incredibly profound. I'll skip ahead here to the first variation. So this is a piece that really repays constant listening. I've been listening to this piece again and again and again, really since high school. I wanted to finish with another one of my favorite pieces. This is a trio from Cosi Fan Tutte, which is an opera that Mozart wrote I believe it was performed just a year before he died. And it also has this really profound, otherworldly, numinous quality to it. This trio that I'm going to play for you is called Suave Si El Vento. It is basically three people singing about how they hope that the winds are gentle for the sailing journey that's about to begin. This piece, just like the Goldberg Variations, was written near the end of the composer's life, and it has just that profound, otherworldly, numinous quality that we've been talking about in this video. So I'll end with this video. There's really nothing that can be said after hearing music like that, so I'll just end the video here. Wish you all a great weekend, and I'll see you in tomorrow's video.